Good afternoon and welcome back. I will now request my team, let me briefly introduce them to you. Sajjan, I don't know whether you have seen him. Sajjan Kumar Dixit is the chief manager of my studio team. They undertake all recordings for MOOCs courses. They undertake operations of AVU across the country, various remote centers. Some of you are involved with remote center work would know that you have to do a lot of testing of connectivity and your own established equipment at your place, etc. So he is the one who has set up all procedures. He has set up a studio. I don't know whether you have photographs of that studio to show. Maybe you can compile them tonight and tomorrow we can show it. Sushant has been also with the team. He is actually what I call, in the army terms, 2IC or second in command. So whenever Sajjan is missing, Sushant does all the activities. As you would be aware, each one of your institutions would have technical people on whose competence and experience we all rely. So whether it is running the labs, whether handling an equipment, or whether handling a facility is what is required. In most places in academic institutions, particularly technical institutions, there is an unfortunate tendency to underrate the work done by the technical and administrative people. I jokingly say that in an academic institution, you should either be a faculty member or you should have a roll number. If you are neither, then you are not counted. Whereas the institute activities actually run because of a large support staff. We are very proud of our teams. You have seen the workshop team that you have done. All of us need to learn from them. They are not teachers like us, so don't expect cozy explanations as we are all used to. But they do their job damn well, and that is how we survive.
Good evening. Myself Sushant Raktade. I'll be talking to you about how you can use AVU for your interactions towards there, and how you can, from where you can download, and what steps you need to use to start an AVU interaction. So how many of you have attended an AVU session? Most of them. All of them. And how many of you are from a remote center that is associated with IITB? Not many. Okay, so those who are from the remote centers of IITB, we have been conducting AVU sessions at those remote centers. So you guys have that facility at your center to conduct an AVU session. But if you don't, you can also do it at your center through a laptop or through a PC. First of all, you'll need to download AVU from this website, that is www.nmeict.ac.in/NMEICT. You have a downloads button there. If you go to that downloads button, you will see download AVU Classroom version 3.7. Then there are guidelines to how to set up the AVU Classroom at a remote center. But it will also give you an idea of how to do the interaction sessions at the remote centers. So if you download this AVU Classroom 3.7, you'll get a download here. So when you click on that, it will install the AVU version 3.7 on your machine. But right now we are using the AVU version 5. So what it will do is, when you download that AVU Classroom, and when you click on that AVU Classroom like this, it will be displayed like this, AVU Classroom. So when you double click that, it will automatically update it to the latest version, that is the 5.0. And it will show an icon like this. AVU. So first of all, you need a laptop with a minimum 4GB RAM and a bandwidth which should be a stable 2 Mbps bandwidth. So first you will need, when you are going to conduct a session, you will have to tell us that you are going to conduct this session on this day and this time. So what we will do is, we'll create a virtual classroom inside AVU. At that time and date, that session will be accessible to you and your students. So after that, on that day, you just have to inform your students that you have to give them the login and passwords, and you have to start your AVU at your end. you will be given the unique username and passwords for AView. That will be given from us. And you'll have to select IIT Bombay T10KT server. And you put in your username and password. We will give you teacher privileges so that you are the teacher and others are the students. So once you put in your username password, you can click login. So once you log in, you will see this screen and you will see a list of classes that are being conducted at that time. So right now there is only one class, that is testing class, as an example. So you will see your class name and you will see a join now button here. So you will have to select that, click on that join now button, and it will take you into that class. So now you have entered that class. So you are the teacher. So you are the teacher. So my name is this testing teacher. So it will appear here at the top. And the other students that are logged in, they will appear at the bottom. How many students that you have. So but you have entered the classroom, but you have not started your audio and video streams. So for that, you need to click on the video button here. When you click on this, there is an option to select camera, the audio bandwidth that you want to produce it, and the microphones. So you might not know what camera you have connected, there are very different audio systems in the PC. So to check that, there is a check audio video button here. So when you click on that, it will give you some instructions to test your microphone. So you can click test. And when you speak, it will be get recorded. And you can hear that sound again. So if it's not been recorded, that means the selection here is not proper. So you can see, if you see, there are two or three Realtek and microphone options here. So when you select the proper option there and test, then you will be able to record your sound. And that will confirm that your audio has been recorded in AView. Then you can test speakers.
AView Classroom is a simple, user-friendly video conferencing software.
You can say that your speakers are working fine.
It provides wide opportunity to an experienced faculty.
And there is a bandwidth test that this is very important, because if your bandwidth is not proper, then your audio interactions will not be proper. There will be a lot of breakage in the audio, there will be freeze videos. So that has to be minimum 2 Mbps always, at every time. So if you click on that, it will check your bandwidth and it will show you that if your bandwidth is excellent, it is above 3 Mbps. If it is below that, then you have to contact your system administrator and tell them that you need a minimum stable 2 Mbps line on your laptop or wherever you are conducting that session. Because without that, the session will not be proper. So then there is a camera option here. You will get all the cameras that you have connected. If you have connected an external camera, it will show you the external camera here. Now this PC is having only the USB camera here. So it is showing me USB 2.0 camera. So once that is done, you can just say if it is okay. And then here you can select the camera, the microphone that you have connected. This record session is just for local recording, actually records all the session inside the AView server. If you want that, you can just click on record, or if you don't want, you just tick it off. Then click start. So once you start, your video appear on the right hand side top corner. This is your video, what is being published to other students. If you want to see like how it is, just start it, and after that you can just close it from here so that it doesn't come in between, because there's so much little space in here. You can always get it back by clicking on the video button here. So you are going to give a presentation, so you'll have PPTs or PDFs or slides like that. What you can do is, you can download those PPTs or PDFs in the AView, so through which you can display those PDF and PPTs to all the students. So there is a library button here. There is an upload option. When you click on upload, you can browse your PPT, select it, and upload it. Right now, we suggest that you keep your slides or PPTs size a bit smaller, minimum 5 20 Mbps is acceptable, but it depends on your bandwidth, how much bandwidth you have to upload that file. It will upload, but it will take a longer time. But so if the file size is smaller, it will take not more time to upload. So once you upload that file, it will show up in this list. So for example, I'm clicking that. I have already uploaded it. You double click on it, your PPT will appear. So like this, your PPT will appear. So now, while giving presentations, everybody knows that we have a habit of, you know, there is, if you click a mouse, it will go to the next page, or you will have the keyboard keys to go previous and backwards. But in AVU, you don't have that shortcut facility. Instead of that, there is a buttons here. This is forward and backward. So you'll need to use that for forward and backward. Or you can just go to any page wherever you want, like 40. We'll skip to that page. You can come back to some previous page also. Like this, you can also upload a PDF files. You can also upload PPT files. And if you want your users that they should be able to download that file, there is an option here. There is, if you allow this, then the user at their end, they can just right click on that PPT and download that file. So you need to select this option to allow them to download. Otherwise, if you don't want, you can just switch it off. And there are many more other options here to zoom, to fit to screen. And the most important thing, the pointer. So right now, you are seeing this pointer here. But when you are conducting an AVU session, the students won't be able to see this pointer, what you are seeing right now. The students won't be able to see it. So for that, there is an option called pointer here, mouse pointer. If you click on that, then it will give you a small red dot. So that will move along with your pointer, so that this pointer is also visible at other centers. So they can follow you. Also, there are annotations available. You can highlight. You can write something. There is erase option also. So this is about the presentation. There is also a whiteboard facility available in this. For the whiteboard facility to work, you need a take note which can be attached to a laptop or a PC from where you are going to give the AVU sessions. So what that does is, whatever you write on that board, it's like a blackboard only. Whatever you write on that blackboard, it is visible here on this whiteboard. So you can write, or if you want to draw any diagrams or anything, you can write on this. So this whiteboard facility is also available, and there are, you know, you can change the color of lines, you can change the font, and there are other options here where you can erase it also. So this works like a blackboard, virtual blackboard. You already have some shapes that you can directly. So these are the documents and the whiteboard options that are available here. You can switch between these two anytime. So when you switch to document, the document automatically gets reflected at the student end. If you switch to whiteboard, it automatically gets reflected at the student end. Then there is also a desktop sharing option. So it's like if you have a software or anything that it is not, you know, insert in AVU, you want to show it on your PC. What you can do is this, you can use this desktop sharing option where you just click on desktop and select desktop sharing. Or else there is a software. You can also share that application itself, only that application, not the whole desktop. So there are two options here. So I'm selecting screen area and start desktop sharing. So when you start this desktop sharing, there automatically a dialog box appears on the student screens, and they see your whole desktop. So whatever you do on your desktop, that will be visible here, so that you can use that to explain your software or other parts. You have to stop desktop sharing if you don't. And you can switch in these between these tabs anytime. That will automatically get reflected at the student end. Then comes the interaction part. So there will be students at their end, and if they have a question there, if they have a question, so they can't tell you that they have a question because you don't see them at the time of presentation. So what they do is, if they have a question, they press the hand raise button there. They have a, you know, this, they have the same facility at their end. So this here, they have an option of hand raise. So if they click that button, you will see a question mark here. So that will tell you those students have a question there and you want to interact with them. So you just click on those students. So right now this is a dummy. So right click on that student and press start interaction. So when you press start interaction, that person is gets connected to you. But for you to see that, you need to go to the video wall button. So this video wall button will show you and the student at the same time. So this is the student and this is the teacher. If you click on the student, this video gets full screen. So now you are connected to the students and now you can speak to that student and they can speak to you. Here you can also select multiple students. Now there is only one, but you can also select multiple students at the same time. They will appear in small boxes around the corner. There is one more option, like there is a presenter control option. So if there are students at their end, if you want them to present to other students, what you can do is you can give them the presenter control and they can upload PPT and they can give the presentation. So for that you can just give them the presenter control, right? You can select them, then there is this make presenter option here at the bottom. So if you make them presenter, they become the teacher and they can upload PPTs, they can give the presentation from their end. You become the student for that time. You can take back that control also. So in between these, the session which are going on, there are options like chat and questions here. There's a chat tab, there's a questions tab. So what in chat, this chat tab is visible to everyone who is connected. All the people who are connected, they can see the chat, they can post some chats. So this, whatever you post here, is seen to you and everybody. But if the person wants to ask a question, so you can ask them to put the questions in this questions tab. So what this does is, person will put a question, it will appear on this question. This will also be visible to everyone. And what this can help you with is, like, if the other center has the same question, what he can do is, if a question appears here, if he sees that he has the same question, he can select that question and vote for it. That means that the center has the same question, so he has voted for it, and you will see that two or three people have the same question, and you can later take it up and answer it. Then another chat feature is there that you can decide, if you want a specific person to send a specific person a chat. So you can just right click and click on private chat. So this private chat, what it does is, it only is displayed on that person to whom which you are sending. This is not visible to everyone. This is only visible to you and the person which you have selected. So you can do this private chat also if you don't want all the people to see that chat. Then there is a polling option. So it's like KBC. So you post a question and the people have option to select multiple choice answers. If you select that, and it will automatically give you a bar chart, how many people have answered this, how many people have answered this. So this polling feature is very important. Here you can just create question, a multiple choice question. Whatever you type a question, and you can give multiple choices. So you can say add choices, then you can type in the choices and click save. When you click that save, it will display like this. And once you want this question to be posted at every student, what you do is you select that question and start polling. So what this does is, when you press the start polling, the question and with the options appears at that student end, and he has the option to select any one of them and post it. So what happens when they post it, you just click here and view results. So when you click on that, you view results. You see how many participants have answered B, how many participants have answered A, how many participants have answered C. So this gives you instant feedback about your question and the options that you have given. And it also shows you the number of students that have answered this question. So these are basically the basic workthrough of an AVIEW interaction that you need to know. If you are facing any problems regarding the audio issues and you know, there are a lot of times the people don't plug their earphones or plug their headphones properly. So there are problems regarding the audios. So what you can do, tell them is there is a this test option, check audio or video option is always there with at their end also. You can tell them to check that also. Or if you are a remote center and you have that already the facility there, you can just contact people here and we will solve that problem. But during the session, if there are you know, audio issues and audio video issues, you can just tell them that you please go to that check audio video option, and that will automatically test their audio video, and you can just tell them that check this, and after that you just come again and log in again. So that will solve the audio video problem. Okay, there is one echo test option here. There is, if you click that,
you may talk something along with this audio. Your voice will be played back after 10 seconds. If you do not hear this pre-recorded audio in the playback, there is no echo.
So if you hear only your voice with the presenter voice,
check,
there is no echo. So that this is another confirmation regarding if your audio is properly connected. Then it automatically shows you. So that's the basic workthrough of AVIEW. If you have any questions right now, you can just post or live quiz is not activated. This live quiz is not activated. It's not actually that tab is right now not active, so that's why I've skipped that part.
How can we practice by doing this?
You can download this software from this the website that I've shown you. You just go through that, the settings and all, and you also have that AVIEW guidelines file on that on our website.
No, but if, how do they practice? Because they need a server. It's a good suggestion. First of all, I would like to further add to whatever he has stated, that AVIEW, the server end as well as the client end, is entirely open source software. What he has talked about is the client side, which can be downloaded and you can start using. But there is a server side which is much more complex. Actually, their team have installed that server side here. It requires two or three different server instances. So one is a streaming server, one is a database server, one is a content server. All of those are managed. There is nothing extraordinary about it. You can also install it. One problem with the backend server is that the streaming server that we use or AVIEW uses is still a proprietary software. They use Adobe streaming server. But as far as the other server instances are concerned, they use MySQL, Mongo, and such things, which are okay. The point I'm making is, those of you who want, they can use the AVIEW facility even within your own institutions. For example, you have large classes for first year students. You invariably pack them up into 100 or 150, and yet you may have 400 students. I have seen everywhere these are taught in batches by different people. Now why not select out of the four teachers the one person who is the best expert on a certain topic and let that person give lecture in that topic to all students. Let students assemble in different classrooms. We routinely use AVIEW within IIT Bombay on a couple of occasions every year, like the director addresses all newcomers. The 1,200 people are admitted. Now instead of putting them in convocation hall, they can be put into three or four halls like this, where TAs are there, and you can actually give a lecture. We have done that for several other courses. So this is one usage. About practice, you require for practicing three or four partners, one of whom will become a teacher, the other will be students. It is not necessary to set this up across different locations necessary. Although I would take this as one of the early collaborating activities. So from amongst you, I propose that we form teams or groups of say 10, 15, 20 people each, where each one in turn acts as a teacher. The other 19 act as 19 groups. So imagine at each place there are a group of people. Even that can be simulated in real life, because it is not that at every college that you come from there is only one participant like you. There are places where there are multiple people. So all of them can form one group, another group at some other place, third group at some other place. To facilitate this, we will actually work out a schedule in the month of April, yes, where we will keep such classrooms by different names. Only the collaborating teams have to tell us which one of them is going to be the coordinator of that collaborative. So that coordinator we will designate as teacher, and all other members of the teams with respect to IPR as students. And we will give you slots. So much before you start interacting with the actual participants of the future FDPs, you can actually interact and examine and perfect each of these facilities. We will also participate as students during that slot, but not as domain experts, but as technical support people. So if anybody has a problem, the problem can be raised to the teacher through a chat or through audio-video interaction, and our student will be able to answer that question.
Yeah.
Okay. So we can work out such a thing. Do you think this is useful?
Okay.
So I think my own ambition is that AVU should become the Skype of India. So it should become as simple as that. And let us see how long it takes. It took us quite some time to convince our colleagues in Amruta University to open source that software. But after they have done that, the usage has increased. The hackathon, for example, that is going to be conducted by MHRD on 1st and 2nd. So the coordination between 26 different centers is going to be done using AVU. This is definitely useful. There are two aspects that I would like to stress. Whenever you have an audio-visual interaction, it is like people sitting across here. So there are two aspects to it. One is the activity is synchronous. So it doesn't matter how far and where you are. It appears as if you are at the same place, same time. So there is a synchronicity. Now, whenever a synchronous activity happens, the activity acquires spontaneity. So if somebody asks a question spontaneously, somebody answers the question spontaneously. Asking a question after a lot of thinking and answering it during discussion forum is actually a very different process. But spontaneously raising a question and spontaneously answering a question has its own charm and has its own advantage. You would have noticed in your own classes many times that suddenly a student asks a question out of the blue, and on the spot you are able to think and give an answer, or some other student gives an answer which you could not have done had you thought for 2 days about what question to ask and what answer to. Spontaneity is not just beautiful, spontaneity also has a whole lot of creativity implied in it. Spontaneity is what we miss in online education. AVU interaction will bring that spontaneity. So with this, I think we'll close for the session. I would like to thank Sushant and Sajjan. Give them a big hand.